Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part two of solving compound linear inequalities, and we do the following three problems on this video. Some compound inequalities containing the word and can be written in a more compact form. So for instance, what if we have negative 2 is less than x and x is less than 3? So basically we want a number that is bigger than negative 2, right? If negative 2 is smaller than x, then x is bigger than negative 2. So we want a number that's bigger than negative 2 and at the same time smaller than 3. A compact way of writing that is to say that x is between negative 2 and 3. And we could write it like this: negative 2 is less than x is less than 3. So actually, if this was the problem, our solution, we would write this in interval notation, would just look like this. It's in between negative 2 and 3. So here's another example. 1 is less than or equal to x, and x is less than or equal to 10. How could we write that in compact form? Go ahead and try that, and then write the answer using interval notation. So basically, this is saying x is between 1 and 10, right? So I've got 1 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 10. You're looking for numbers between 1 and 10, and they can include 1 and 10. So in interval notation, that would be 1 to 10. How about this next one? 2 is less than x plus 3, and x plus 3 is less than 8. All right, got any ideas for that one? Well, notice that again, we've got the same thing here. It has to be the same, like it has to be x and x, or x plus 3 and x plus 3. So this thing, whatever it is, x plus 3, it's bigger than 2, and at the same time less than 8. So this could be written as 2 is less than x plus 3, which is less than 8. And this, in fact, is a more compact way of writing this and solving this compound inequality. You could also go back and forth. So in other words, if something was written as 2 is less than x plus 3 is less than 8, you could read that as, well, that means 2 is less than x plus 3, and at the same time, x plus 3 is less than 8, which of course is, whoops, I've got an extra less than symbol there, which is of course what I started out with. So these are equivalent to each other. So let's go ahead and try to solve this problem. 2 is less than x plus 3, and x plus 3 is less than 8. So let's say this was the problem. Solve 2 is less than x plus 3, and x plus 3 is less than 8. If it was presented to you this way, we would solve each separately. So we would subtract 3 from both sides. And that says negative 1, right, because 2 minus 3 is negative 1, is less than x. Now remember, that's the same thing as saying x is bigger than negative 1, right? If negative 1 is smaller than your solution, then all your solutions are bigger than negative 1. And, okay, let's solve this one. Solving this inequality, we're going to subtract 3 from both sides as well. So we have x is less than 5. So we're looking for numbers that are greater than negative 1 and less than 5. Okay, I'm not going to go through the whole process of writing both of those on a number line and doing an intersection, but hopefully you're okay going directly to the answer here. What would that mean? You want numbers bigger than negative 1 and at the same time less than 5. So let's say here's 0, here's negative 2, 2, 4, and 6. All right, so what would this be? Bigger than negative 1 means it's to the right of negative 1, and it goes up to 5. So our final answer will look like this. Now remember, what you could do is graph each of these separately, and then you're looking for the overlap. Right, so our solution here would be written as between negative 1 and 5. And remember, that's not an ordered pair. This is the answer in interval notation. Okay. Now, if you're going to do it in sort of a compact form, this is saying negative 1 is less than x is less than 5. Negative 1 is less than x is less than 5. That's basically what that means in interval notation, right? Negative 1 to 5. So this is the other way of writing it. Let's take this original problem, 2 is less than x plus 3, and x plus 3 is less than 8, and write it in compact form. So what would the compact form be? We would say 2 is less than x plus 8, x plus 3, which is less than 8. And now you can solve this all in one step. Instead of solving two separate pieces, you could just subtract 3 from all three parts here. I don't want to, there's not really three sides because there's this middle. You're trying to isolate x. So if I subtract 3, I have to subtract 3 and I have to subtract 3. I'm trying to get just an x in the middle. So we have 2 minus 3 is negative 1, which is less than x, which is less than 5. So you see how much faster that was to get the solution. So if it's in this compact form, you can directly go to it. Now, are there numbers between negative 1 and 5 is the question. Yes. If it was the other way around, like I had the 5 on the left, there would be no solution because you can't have a number no solution because there aren't any numbers that are bigger than 5 and at the same time less than negative 1. Think about that. Try to think of a number that's bigger than 5 and at the same time less than negative 1. Not going to happen. But there are numbers that are bigger than negative 1 and less than 5. For instance, 0, 4, etc. Everything that you see on this graph up here. Before going on to another problem, keep in mind this negative 1, 5 is not an ordered pair because you have to look at the problem in context. We're looking to the solution to this compound inequality. All right? So since these were strictly less than symbols, there was no equals, you end up using parentheses. It kind of looks like an ordered pair, but it is not an ordered pair. It's a solution in interval notation. Right, so here's the next problem. Negative 1 is less than x plus 1 is less than or equal to 4. You could split this up into two pieces, but it's easier to go ahead and leave it as is. And keep in mind this. If you have a less than in two places, right, then the smaller number must be on the left. So notice this is 1, negative 1, and this is 4. If the coefficient of x is still positive. Okay? So it makes sense that this is probably going to have a solution. So we're going to go ahead and try to isolate x. So we'll subtract 1 from both sides. I'm sorry, from all three parts. So I get negative 1 plus negative 1 is negative 2, is less than x, is less than 3. So I'm looking for numbers in between negative 2 and 3. This is less than or equal to 3, sorry. So my answer in interval notation, it will be, whoops, it doesn't touch 2, so my answer will be negative 2, 3. If you were to graph it on a number line, here's negative 2, there's 0, etc. We would have in between negative 2 and up to and touching 3. Right, here's the next one. This one's a little bit trickier because notice it says 2 minus x. So when you solve this inequality, be careful. At some point, you're going to have to multiply or divide by a negative. All right, so why don't you try this problem on your own? See if you can solve this compound inequality and then go ahead and write your answer in interval notation and graph it on a number line. All right, so let's see. We're trying to isolate the x. So first of all, let's get rid of this 2 by subtracting 2, but we have to do it to all three parts. So let's see, if I do it to all three parts, that gives me 3 is greater than or equal to, now all I have is a negative x, right? I'm going to write, you could think of that as a negative 1 times x, right? So I'm going to go ahead and write negative 1 times x. is greater than or equal to 1. Now, I need to find out what x is, right? Not what negative 1x is. What are the possibilities? So I need to multiply or divide by negative 1. Most people like to divide, so I'm going to do it as division. So if I divide by negative 1, remember, this has to switch. It'll now be less than or equal, and that has to switch. It'll be less than or equal. You have to be very careful that you do that step. So now that gives me, what's 3 divided by negative 1? Negative 3. This is now really a less than or equal, and now this becomes just x, and this will be less than or equal. 1 divided by negative 1 is negative 1. So my solutions are between negative 3 and negative 1. So if I were going to graph it, let's see, here's 0. And here's 1, here's negative 1, right? Negative 2, negative 3. Right? They're less than or equal. So are there numbers between negative 3 and negative 1? Yes, there are. Right? In other words, x has to be bigger than negative 3. So we are going to go bigger than negative 3 and all the way up to negative 1. So our solution in interval notation is negative 3, negative 1. I thought I would get to the two tricky problems on this video, where it's not always going to be a solution in between two numbers, but we'll have to go on to the third video for that. So we're going to do another video with AND problems, where they might not be in this compact form. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.